Do you know where to find the best food and drinks in Jacksonville? Is there a local spot that you know has the best birria tacos, donuts, or IPAs?
We are holding the first ever George Moore's Jack's Picks, where each week we select a category and you get to vote for your favorite business. Place your vote, then the top three businesses will be selected for an in-dealership side-by-side taste test.
Justin Moore, General Manager of George Moore Chevrolet, with another episode of George Moore's Jack's Picks. This week, espresso and very beach heavy. All three places located at the beach. Sago Coffee on 3rd Street, Southern Grounds in Neptune Beach, and Pura Bean on Beach Boulevard near 1122. Our very special guest judge back again, Officer Singleton. Sago is our winner for best espresso.
Woohoo! Woo.
Why are we at a brewery in Jacksonville Beach? Well, George Moore Chevrolet grew up in Jacksonville Beach. And a great debate at the beaches that we are going to settle today is who makes the best sub.
Yes.
And your winner, with only 6 points, two first place votes,
gosh,
second place votes,
which is unbelievable.
Off of Penman Road, which is their Italian
host. That's good.
Italian meats, provolone, lettuce, tomato, onion, and your choice of sweet or hot pepper.
No lettuce, thank you.
It was a great sub.
It was good. Great.
Side
show
glass.
So we got 42 degrees.
Thank you. And 42
on
top.
All right, okay. Hi, Justin Moore, General Manager of George Moore Chevrolet, and really excited for our first installment of George Moore's Jack's Picks. You know, it's everybody loves talking about food. I love eating food, and Jacksonville has a lot of great food to offer. So we took what you all said were the three best bagel places in Jacksonville, and we are going to blind taste test them side by side. So that's what makes this contest unique. We have Holy Moly on Bay Meadows Road, Bite a Bagel on County Road 210, and Bagels R Us, which has three locations around town.
This is it right here. What do you think, Bill?
I'm thinking cream cheese can be added. So we're just all about the bagel right now.
So with 2.5 first place votes, Holy Moly Bagel is our winner.
Holy Moly!
This one is a heated debate. If you're from the beach, you know and love Sonati's. And if you're from Arlington, Donut Shop is in your blood. So we are going to settle the debate.
It's fluffy, light and fluffy.
A lot lighter, a lot fluffier. It's a good fluffy donut.
Cut some up for everyone if you'd like.
So is that custard filled?
Yes.
I wonder
this
what this
like
one's
a custard.
It's a surprise.
Best donut in Jacksonville goes to Sonati's. This week, what I'm very excited about is best brisket, and our judges, we have GM World Class Tech, Mike. Sergeant Roa, and Officer Higby from JSO. Guys, why were you selected as a brisket judge? Mike, you want to go first?
Kind of an amateur, but possibly one day professional smoker. Like to smoke in my spare time. Like to smoke everything. Brisket's definitely one of my favorite things to do.
I was picked to be here because I'm being assigned to this new area. So we are here reaching out to the community and the public. That's what they picked me.
I was picked. I do smoking on my days off. That's my main hobby I do. So one day, hopefully, being able to bring my smoking out to the world as well.
So in no specific order, the three voted on Bearded Pig, which has two locations, one at the beach and one in San Marco. Woodpeckers down in Orangedale near the Shands Bridge. And Atlantic Beach Barbecue from Atlantic Beach. So guys, here's the first one. Take a bite, be very vocal, tell us what you like, what you don't like, and take some notes.
This one has a more like a from being Spanish, feels like more Mexican type of chicharron or type of things that we do. So this one has totally different taste, all three of them. That's what I was looking for. They taste like carnitas in Spanish. If you go to like a taco stand or whatever, order carnitas, this is what you're gonna get. Which is good, it's still good.
Yeah, I don't mind it. It's a little on the drier side.
The winner was Bearded Pig, right?
The top three that received votes, Vinny's on Beach Boulevard, D and LP on 3rd Street and Jack's Beach, and Carmine's Pie House in Riverside. Pizza One is out here. Let's start eating.
Pizza One.
Oh yeah.
Nice. And I have a feeling
the
this
last
is,
one I had to assist it a little bit.
Yep. Yep. Now at least that looks better.
It's so flavorful.
So as you all voted, we've got Shut 'Em Down on the west side, Bold Chicken in Murray Hill, and Beach Road Chick, well, I'm gonna call it Beach Road Chicken Dinners because that's what it's always been, down on Atlantic. Our judges.
This is breading, it's pretty good.
Definitely has some kick.
It does have a little more kick.
That's
a nice flavor though.
Yeah.
Very juicy.
Chris,
that's
funny.
Yeah. That's why I said audio, you almost died.
So,
check him out very wrong.
Yeah. So we've selected five of the city's best hazy IPAs. We have Karate in the Garage from Southern Swells, Feed Your Head from Rev, Bullet Bob from Strings, What's the Juice from Main and Six, and King of the Hill from Fishweir. Let's get started.
I don't have any strong reactions to this.
When I think of an IPA, this is what I think.
It's the winner, Rev.
Yeah, I can still go there.
Beer what?
Yeah.
Beer what? What beer number was that?
It was beer number five. Beer number five was the winner.
Oh,
I would say like if you ask people blindly on the street, you say what's the best IPA in Jacksonville, most
that's
people would
one.
Say Karate. Welcome back. Week four of George Moore's Jack's Picks. And on the menu this week, Berea Tacos. So you all voted, and we have Berea Tacos from Dos Vatos Tacos, Añejo Riverside, and One Night Taco Stand.
It's really good.
Not quite as spicy or saucy as I was expecting.